offside action, and we're just about set to kick off. This coin toss presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. The pregame festivities are over, and we're just about set to get this game underway. He's to the 20. They'll bring him down at the 27. The quarterback leads the team out on the field for the first drive. And he's taken down at the 30. And he hits him hard at the 30-yard line. And they make the stop at the 33-yard line. He picked up around 3 yards on the draw play. He puts it away, and it's a great kick. And down he goes at the 33. The quarterback brings his troops out onto the field for the first drive of the game. He's taken down around the 40-yard line. That's a 7-yard gain.
And it was a simple throw right back to the halfback, who did a good job of getting some positive yards on the play.
Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. Tackle at the 37-yard line. A loss on that one as he couldn't get past those big linemen.
You got that right. They sacrificed their bodies in there and stuffed him.
The quarterback in the gun with 5 receivers. Brought down around the 49-yard line.
That is money in the bank. Sometimes you just can't stop a good combination.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 49. Hands it to the back. Runs outside for a nice gain.
That's a gain of 5 on the play. That brings him second and 5.
They'll bring him down around the 36-yard line.
I think he was going to go to his tight end the whole way, but the defense didn't expect it. Sometimes those big guys can fool defenders into thinking they're blocking.
First and 10, ball on the 36. And he's knocked out immediately after the catch.
I'll tell you something. I'm loving this quarterback's confidence more and more as this game goes on. He's really throwing the ball with some purpose.
Quick pass. He's pushed out of bounds around the 10-yard line. It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here. He steps up. And he's got all the time in the world. Looking for 6 over the middle. He got it. Touchdown. kicks the PAT. So an 8-play, 66-yard drive, and it results in a touchdown.
An amazing drive for this offense. Outstanding execution. If you're the defense, you've got to do something to try to change things up to get this quarterback out of sync.
It's fielded at the 2. At the 30. The 50. Knocked out of bounds. Right around the 34. The Buffaloes are right where they want to be early in this one, partner.
Well, this is what their coach talked about. Getting off to a great start. The defense did their job, and it's nice to see the offense move the ball down the field and also get some points on the board.
You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their minds. They just need to go out there and play. Quick throw, and he tackles him hard at the 25-yard line. He might have a chance. Good tackle there in space.
Play call there by the offensive coordinator. Just give it to the back and let him find his way into the end zone.
Here's the PAT to tie this thing up. He splits the uprights with the extra point. UCLA lines up for the kickoff. He just drills this one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The offense ready for the first play of this drive. They moved the ball extremely well on their last possession on their way to the end zone.
You know, when this defense went over to the sideline, based on the way they've been playing so far, this defense coordinator has got to live it. He's got to get in their face. He's got to challenge them. He's got to get their emotions going. Because when you play defense, it's not just about X's and O's. It's about attitude and playing with a lot of confidence.
From their own 30-yard line, second down. Throws incomplete.
He'll learn he doesn't always need to use his cannon. Sometimes precision is more important than power.
Throws it out and it falls incomplete.
Nothing clicking there. Let's see if they can make a few adjustments before their next series.
They're coming after this punter. Gets to about the 41-yard line. I don't think either team has a clear advantage so far. Let's see if they can make some plays and get a little separation. Carries the ball for a nice game. He's scrambling. And he's tackled at the 49-yard line. Throw out to the receiver, and down he goes at the 37. Heading for the corner. Decent run here, right side. Receiver's got it on the screen. He's tackled right around the 36-yard line. We played one quarter. We get a tie game at 7-7. Welcome back. Tight game here in the second quarter as we begin play.
That's a diving interception. What a play.
That is exactly the kind of play you want to see from a safety. He needs to be able to read the play and then make the interception.
From their own 20-yard line, first down.
Super effort by the tailback to pick up a nice gain and a first down. He's really a good-looking ball carrier.
Gains his way to the 43-yard line. From their own 43-yard line, it's first down. Made around the 47-yard line.
He is such a reliable target. You throw it anywhere near him, and this guy's going to get his hands on it and make a catch.
Man left, man left. You're not ready. 46 is right there. Check in. Run.
They go to the back, and he's hit immediately in the backfield. 2-yard loss for the halfback. From the 49-yard line, it's second down. Fires out to his wideout. And he's taken down to the 39-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 10 yards. That makes it third and three.
They got to him, and he did not get the first down. He's going to aim this one to the sideline, try to kick it out of bounds. So this one goes into the end zone, and that'll be a touchback. The offense will take the field, hoping for a better result than their last drive.
And I don't think this defense will lay down lightly. They're going to try to continue to rattle this guy.
Quick throw, incomplete, wanted his receiver.
That was textbook coverage by the defense. That's exactly what you want to do on every single pass play, but it doesn't always happen.
In second and 10, ball on the 20-yard line. To the back quickly, off his hands, incomplete. And he shoved out of bounds at about the 33-yard line. It out to about the 43. And he throws it away.
Even though they didn't sack him, the pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
Over the middle to his tailback. And he's level at the 41-yard line. Feeds it to the back. They bring him down in the backfield.
I don't think the play developed the way it was supposed to, and the net result is a loss.
From the 42-yard line, it's second down. Slings it. That's a great tackle at the 34. And they get him in the backfield for a loss.
Nothing doing that time. Defender stayed home, blocking wasn't there, and down he went.
It's fourth down, and they're going to try to go for it. Five wide. He's going to try and scramble. And he can't get away from the pressure. And they'll take over on downs. This is the point in the game where you don't want to make any mistakes that give the other guys a reason to feel more confident going into halftime. He might not be able to get the pass off. Quick throw to the back, it's incomplete. From their own 38-yard line, second down. And they make the stop at the 42-yard line. Taken down immediately. Nice gain, but not enough for the first down.
Yeah, that's a nice play there. They did everything right except get enough yards for the first down.
And here's the... Wait a minute. The upback's got it. Tackle at the 48-yard line. Defense stiffens on fourth down, and the ball will change hands. You always want to go in the locker room with momentum, so as we get closer to halftime, I think we'll see more and more attempts to create big plays. There's a strike complete. He tackles him for a loss. But he didn't have much of a chance on that play.
Boy, this defense has a lot of speed. They're all over him by the time he caught the ball.
Now he tries to buy some time. UCLA is going to have to use their second time out of the half. Third down now, and they need to get it down to the 38. Nowhere to go on the quarterback scramble. He is drilled at the 41.
Boy, Brad, that was a big hit on the quarterback. I'm going to be interested to see how he responds from this hit and whether or not he comes after his offensive lineman and challenges them to start playing a little bit better.
Calls for the fair catch. I give the defense credit, but right now I think it's more a case of sloppy offense.
Yeah, you got to recognize that both defenses have come into this game with the right mindset. They're very well prepared. But I'm with you. It's one thing to have great defense. It's another thing when those defenses are going up against offenses that just are not clicking right now and hitting on all cylinders.
Last time out, the offense wasn't able to convert on fourth down.
Brad, this offense, the last time they were out there, went for it on fourth down and came up short. And I'm all for being aggressive. But I really think you've got to be smart when it comes to when to go for it on fourth down and when to punt and try to affect field position. Let's see if this offensive coordinator and play caller has learned from some of his mistakes in the past.
Second down and seven. Ball on the 28. And catch there on second down.
Yep, it was good enough to get him the first down. That's just a nice play.
And we'll probably see how far he can throw it, as it should be the last play before the half. He sails it long. Picked off. Played a half of football. We're even at seven in this one.
played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. Defense has been dominant in this game. Yards very hard to come by. But David, as we get deeper and deeper into this game, the natural assumption is that the pressure goes to the offense to do something.
Yeah.
How much pressure is on the defense not to make that catastrophic mistake?
Well, that's the conundrum you get in. I mean, it makes it exceptionally tough because you want to play perfect and you want to get them to punt every single time, but it's not the way it works. And it's those big plays that you usually see that kill the defenses and break their backs. And you can hold them great, Reese, on first down, second down, it's third and long. You're in a perfect situation. You give up that one play for 80, and it changes the whole complexion of the game. So I think you got to have a little bit of both. It can't just be great defense the whole time. Usually the teams that play great defense can keep you in it, but only for so long. At some point, that offense has to get something going.
Looking forward to seeing this second half. I think there's certainly a want for victory.
A want and a need for victory. Some teams need this victory, Reese Davis.
Want, need, got to go get it either way. Brad and Kirk are there to deliver.
All right, Reese, David, thanks, guys. Just about set to start the third quarter. And he got all of this one. Great kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. A lot of times you'll see teams start to clinch up a little bit when games stay close well into the second half. You need to stay loose, keep doing what you've been doing all week in practice, and execute when it's time. Tackle at the 35-yard line.
First down here, Brad, by this offense. The receiver's running the football. You got to think, as a defensive coordinator, it's one thing to try to defend and kind of your traditional offensive attack, but here you got to start worrying about what is this wide receiver going to do. Puts a lot of pressure on the defense and the defensive mindset on how they want to try to slow this offense down.
The tailback picks up about 3 yards on the option play. Second down at 7 coming up here. Ball on their own 38.
Here we go.
Gets it out quickly. Brought down at about the 41.
That's a gain of 3 on the play. That'll bring up 3rd and 4.
He's taken down at the 38. Loss of 3.
Really, they just had nowhere to go after the catch.
Down he goes at the 30. You don't want to squander any possessions, but maybe now's the right time to dip into your bag of tricks a little. Think about some gadget plays to catch the defense napping. They come out on an empty backfield. Tackled after decent pickup. Green gets it to his tailback. They'll bring him down around the 41-yard line. They'll line up with 5 wide receivers. Tackled after a decent run up the gut. There are 5 wide receivers split out. The quarterback in the gun. He's at the 40. He's at the 30. They'll spread the field with 5 wide. Check out.
run there. Got an opening. What a play to set him up with a first and goal. Never want to see a kid down on the field after a play. Not sure what happened, but hopefully it's nothing serious. First down. They've got four cracks at it inside the five. It's first and goal. Touchdown, Bruins. Nice run and a score by the halfback.
And a nice call by the coach there. Just give it to your main man anytime you're near the goal line.
And he hits the PAT. So a seven-play, 69-yard drive, and that's good for a touchdown.
Brad, that's one of those drives that can just tear your heart out. That can really demoralize a defense when they drive the ball down the field, and a lot of the yards came on the ground.
UCLA lines up for the kickoff. Sends it sailing downfield. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. UCLA's continuing to play extremely tough defense. This has been impressive.
It's just been impressive to watch them play with such an attitude, almost a chip on their shoulder with the energy that they're playing with. I think it's going to require that kind of effort to be able to win this game.
This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. Quick out to his receiver, and he's hit immediately.
Second and two.
It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. Hand off to the right, and down he goes at about the 31. Middle, got his back, and he's tackled at the 31. The punt upcoming, and they're going to come after this one. And he just got stood up right there. The Buffaloes have really surprised everybody in this football game.
They have not been intimidated at all, which is great to see. The attitude and effort of this team put them in a position where they got a shot to win this game here in the second half.
And offense is back on the field after running the ball very well on their last drive.
This offensive line really opened up some big gaps for the running back last time.
Quick throw. UCLA up 7 points. And he carries the ball for a nice gain. Quick pass. He's tackled at the 42. One goes for good yardage and a first down.
Yeah, that's just a nice gain on second down.
Throws a bullet over the middle, and he's taken down at the 8-yard line.
A quarterback's best friend is a receiver he can count on to catch the ball every time he drops back to pass.
And smell the end zone as they look to extend this lead. Straight up the middle, and he'll lose yardage.
Loss of 2 yards on the play. That brings him 6 and 1.
It's been a defensive masterpiece through 3. Who'll draw up points in the final quarter? UCLA's lead is a touchdown. Welcome back to the action here as we resume play here in quarter number 4. UCLA is up by a touchdown. It's on a move, touchdown. Splits the uprights with the extra point. An 8-play, 66-yard drive, and they come away with a touchdown.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He's to the 20. He makes it out to maybe the 23-yard line. We're about set to start things up again. Got a receiver and he dropped it.
Not a great throw by the quarterback, but to be fair, that was pretty good coverage.
From their own 23-yard line, second down. Nice run, and he's brought down. It's fourth down, and the offense is getting set to go for it. They're trying to stop the run here with a goal line defense. He's got it out to his tight end. And they finally push him out at the 38-yard line.
That was a clutch play on fourth down, but they are still down a couple of scores, and it's going to take some work for this team to get back into this game.
From the 38-yard line, first down. On the ground, right side. Makes it out to about the 19. From the 19-yard line, it's first down. The 5, quick throw out to the receiver. And did that play ever develop nicely?
Well, it's all about the receiver on this play. He beat his man off the line and then ran a perfect route. All he had to do after that was make the catch.
Where was the coverage there? There wasn't anybody near him at all. And he adds the extra point. Colorado kicked this one off. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. He's to the 20. And he's taken down at the 22-yard line. You know this is a real crucial time in the game. It could still go either way. UCLA is up a score. And they make the stop at the 32-yard line. Tries to buy some time. He dives and he'll be marked down. And he just gets rid of it.
Even though they didn't sack him, the pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
From their own 33-yard line, second down. Fires that quickly to the tailback. And he is drilled at the 42-yard line. Gets rid of it. Just under two to go in the game. They'll bring him down at the 33. The offense was able to punch it in the end zone on that last drive. They'll come back out looking for more of the same.
You know, when this defense went over to the sideline, based on the way they've been playing so far, this defense coordinator has got to be livid. He's got to get in their face. He's got to challenge them. He's got to get their emotions going. Because when you play defense, it's not just about X's and O's. It's about attitude and playing with a lot of confidence.
That makes it first and 10.
From the 45-yard line, first down, five wide. Quick strike to the receiver, tackle at the 41-yard line.
That makes it 7-6.
He throws left, and he hauls that one in, and he's finally knocked out of bounds at the 8.
That makes it first and goal.
So here we go, first and goal, and a field goal won't cut it. Touchdown. We'll be tied with the extra point. The offense didn't get the playoff in time. Just over a minute in the fourth quarter. And he adds the extra point. to kick this one away. He's to the 20. Tackle at the 31-yard line.
Well, I'm sure the return man would have loved to go for six that time.
You got to hurry here, but you don't want to rush things and make a critical mistake.
This is when things get a little prickly. You need your playmakers to really come through here.
He's taken down at about the 49. He's on the run. Now he's going to run and watch out. Slides down to the ground. Scrambling around. Tackle made the 37-yard line. And a good decision there.
Yeah, he didn't have anybody open downfield, and instead of panicking and throwing the ball into coverage or maybe throwing the ball away, he had the composure to recognize the open field and had the athletic ability to get the first down. That's a nice job.
He gets it up, and it hits the crossbar. No good. Well, that's the end of regulation, and this game is still unsettled, so we're going to overtime. Back to the action here, and we get ready for overtime. Gets it out quickly to the back, but he can't haul it in. From the 25-yard line, second down. And a nice catch there before he stepped out of bounds. Now he tries to buy some time, and they got him.
Man, these guys can be aggressive. When you stand back there and take hits like that, you definitely are going to feel it the next day.
Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 13-yard line. And he's out of bounds. That's a loss. Got a man open. Touchdown. Tacks on the extra point. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 25. Here's a screen pass. Gets it to the back. He goes out of bounds at the 18.
That's good for a gain of 7 yards. That'll bring up second and 3.
Go on.
throws it in a hurry. Brought down right around the 10-yard line. From the 10-yard line, first down. They'll run it. And he's tackled right around the 12-yard line.
Never really had a shot. They were on him almost as soon as he took the handoff.
Quarterback in the gun with five receivers. Steps up. Quick throw out to the receiver. That'll be a gain of 3 yards.
That's a nice catch by the junior wide receiver, but an even better effort by the defense to keep him from going anywhere.
Third down, 9 to go. Ball on the 9-yard line. Throws out, got his back again. They bring him down in the backfield. Touchdown.
Oh, man. That was a pressure-packed play, and they came through. Here we go again.
They'll line up for the extra point in an attempt to tie the game. He splits the uprights with the extra point.
Well, it's going to take another round at least. You can bet the coaches are going to look to be more aggressive on both sides of the ball.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 25-yard line. Hit as he threw, and he completes it. And down he goes at about the 13. The stop at the 5-yard line. So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. Touchdown, Colorado! So they draw first blood here in double overtime.
Avoiding field goals in overtime is just huge. Anytime you can get 6 in overtime instead of 3, you're going to be tough to beat.
And he hits the PAT. From the 25-yard line, it's first down. Under pressure, incomplete. And that wasn't the greatest pass in the world.
Well, I don't know how anybody can throw a great pass while getting drilled like that.
Get to that quickly. Tackle at the 20-yard line.
It really wasn't badly played by the defense, but sometimes a good throw and catch just beats you.
It's third and 5. Ball on the 20. They'll spread the field here. Let's see what the defense does with a 5-wide outlook. He gets rid of this one. Throws it out there. Intercepted. Game over. the ball game's over. And our final score of this one, Colorado 35, UCLA 28.
And the UCLA Bruins, 28.
That brings this broadcast to a close. For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler. We'll see you soon for another edition of NCAA Football 14.